In this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football, Presbyterian College took on the third-ranked team in the land, the Chanticleers of Coastal Carolina. And boy, PC played lights out. In fact, led in that ball game a couple of times. We're going to talk to the coach, take a look at those highlights. We're also going to preview this afternoon's contest as PC wants to get back on the winning track as they take on the Buccaneers of Charleston Southern. All that and more in this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football. We welcome you into this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football, along with the coach, Harold Nichols. I'm your host, Eric Thacker. And, coach, congratulations. Despite us not winning the contest against a Chanticleer team who you say arguably could be the best in the country, boy, your young man fought hard and fought to the bitter end.
Yeah, they did. You know, I really think that, you know, a couple things. One, you know, I was really proud of our kids, their effort. I think their you know, that they did a nice job of putting themselves in a position at times during the game to win. Now, all the credit goes to Coastal. They're a very, very talented football team. And I knew that going in, knew it was going to be a challenge. They are definitely up to their billing, being the number three ranked team in the country. You know, they're a solid defensive club. Their quarterback's a really, really good player. We had a hard time tackling the Henderson kid. But, you know, we had our chances during the course of the game there to, to have a say-so in the final outcome. But at the end of the day, you know, we didn't perform well enough to win. But I was proud of the effort of our kids.
Well, the Blue Hose came out offensively, took their opening drive, went in and scored. That's after forcing the Chanticleers to a three down and out, which they had twice. And, in fact, we led, I think, 7 first downs to 1 at one point in the first quarter going into the second quarter. The second quarter kind of favored them with 13 points there. But then the nice thing was is that you take that opening possession of the second half, march that down in and score. And then Presbyterian all of a sudden recaptures the lead. And, boy, I saw the excitement on the sideline because we knew we were in it.
Yeah, it was kind of back and forth there for a little while. You know, we cut it to a one-score game, I think, with maybe about 9 or 10 minutes left. I can't remember how that kind of worked out there at the end. But, you know, at the end of the day, I thought we did play better offensively. We had 27 first downs. We had 450 yards of offense.
And against the Chanticleers.
Yeah, which is pretty good. And I think at the end of the day you know, defensively, you know, we gave up a couple of big plays there in the second half that hurt us, missed some tackles, and we just kind of got wore down there in the second half. But, you know, we had our chances. You know, I think if we'd played a little bit better in special teams, maybe we kind of got some field position there at the end and make a difference. But, you know, at the end of the day, again, you know, we had the two turnovers. They had the one. You know, we have to play better in order to beat a really, really good team like Coastal.
Well, one bright spot for the offense was DeMarcus Rouse running at full speed, totally injury-free now, and then he showed his attributes as he scampered that 52 yards for that first score.
Yeah, it was a good run. You know, DeMarcus keeps getting better each and every week. You know, he's finally healthy and, you know, really has done a nice job playing with the ball and without the ball. And pass protection, blocking on some perimeter runs, did a nice job. I thought Toby Antigua played well.
Made some
great catches, and you know, has really become a difference maker for us offensively, throwing the ball down the field. And I thought Jordan Howland's played well. Jeremiah finally made a splash. So you know, we got to keep building on that, and we're going to need that down the stretch here in the Big South.
All righty, Coach, we have plenty of highlights because it was a great contest, PC and Coastal. Let's dive in.
Sounds
and take
good.
A look.
Here we come out in the first quarter. We've got some defensive highlights here for you to see. Run a little read play, and defense does a nice job, especially the defensive end here. I think that's Kyrie here on your left as you're looking at the screen. Kind of baits the quarterback into pulling the ball and does a nice job on the stop. We come here, they're kind of in a loose red zone, and there's Ed Britt. You know, I tell you what, Ed Britt's played really well all year long. Did a nice job here. You know, they throw a little out cut, and there's Ed driving on the ball, you know, 2 or 3 yard gain. Nice tackle by Ed. Get him here, going away from the scoreboard, and there's Ed on the robber shot right there and does a nice job with the pick and sets us up with great field position on the 25 going in. This is a good look at it here as you're looking into the secondary. There Ed just steps in front, makes a great play. And, again, like I say, Ed's playing at a high level right now and set us up with good field position right there. Here we come in the third quarter. Run a little what we call an outside zone, and bam, there's Ed Britt again.
Nice cut.
I mean, he does a nice job, you know, and he kind of redirects. He's got a good sense and nose for the football and a good open field tackler. Did a nice job right there. Still in the third quarter right here. They're kind of going towards the scoreboard. And there's Obina Tasawe finally getting back healthy, beating the back block by the center. You can see him right there use his hands and then with a host of his teammates right there.
Well, there were some nice defensive stops there. And, Coach, you talked about Ed Britt, and now emerging as one of the best defenders in the backfield in all of conference play.
Yeah, I think so. I think he's having an all-conference type year, doing a nice job, and really good open field tackler shows up on those highlights there.
The other thing is that Alex Ross, who killed us last year at their place, he made some throws, but he didn't get many rushing yards because we were able to contain him a little bit.
Yeah, we did a good job stopping the quarterback runs. You know, wish we'd had as much success stopping the Henderson kid. But but like I say, you know, I think, you know, overall defensively, outside of a few big plays, we did a decent job.
Presbyterian College was able to jump on top first in this contest. As we take a look at our offensive highlights, the Blue Hose and the Chanticleers.
Yeah, we try to change formations a good bit. You know, they're a very talented defensive football team, and we're going to have to make some plays. I think this is the first touchdown run by DeMarcus. It's good to see him finally back healthy, and he can really put him up and put him down and get going there. And, you know, Devin Ritter out there, Chris Hurley setting the edge for him. You know, Devin makes a really nice block here on the corner. There's Dylan Sammons right there sealing the linebacker at center, and there's Toby with a great block on the perimeter right there, and touchdown Blue Hose.
DeMarcus outrunning the angle there.
Here we go back, some motion right here with Jordan Hallams, a little play action pass off of it, run a little corner route right there to Toby on the sideline. Like I say, Toby came up big time and time again, and this is another good throw by Hayes, put in a good spot, and Toby getting his feet in down there, did a nice job. Here back in the second quarter, going towards the scoreboard. Throw a little slant route and great catch by Jordan Hallams. It's really good to see him make a play like that. You know, he's a great kid, love him, one of the hardest workers on the team, and made a really nice play right there on the slant. Here our third quarter going away from the scoreboard. Then we got Jordan and Jeremiah down here in the boundary, and Toby's up to the field. Run a little jet sweep here, a little play action, and there's that Jordan Hallams again right there on the crosser. Hayes does a nice job, good drop right there, keeps his eyes down the field, and makes a really nice throw in there, threading the needle for a big first down. Still in the third quarter right here, I think this is the touchdown catch by Chris. Off a little bootleg action right here. Similar to the play we ran against Furman early in the year. Here we are, got a little run action back here in the backfield with Toby on the jet, and Hayes does a nice job putting it up there, and they get a little confused in the secondary right there and leave the tight end open and Hayes does a nice job finding him, and big first down, big catch right there for us, big touchdown. Here it is, still in the third quarter, going away from the scoreboard again. Got twin set to the field here, and got a little outside run right there. Chris Hurley does a nice job setting the edge, and there's DeMarcus again with another nice run. You know, Chris Hurley has done a really nice job this year, both in the throwing game and the running game right there. And he does a nice job right there finishing the block right there. You can see it in the sideline right there, and does a nice job. Here's the first kickoff, kind of segue here into the special teams a little bit. I thought Brett Wilson kicked great all day.
Sure did.
Good location on the kick. It's about 2 yards deep. You can see Chris Hurley right up the hash here, and bam, big play right there at the 16-yard line. Setting us up with good field position. You know, you make them go the length of the field, it's always a good thing. Here's another kick right here. You can kind of see ball gets into the end zone there, and then there's Chris right up the hash, gets off of a block. Big play right there for us. Here's one of the first punts we had, and I thought Stephen Doerr kicked well all day. You know, he averaged about 42 yards net punting. There's a nice play by Deron Dickey and Cannon Jordan and some of his friends. I thought our kick coverage units were pretty good. Cannon Jordan has always done a nice job with the snaps, and there's Stephen Doerr doing a nice job flipping the field. Like I say, we're down there as Malik Risher and Deron Dickey and Cannon Jordan down there making a play.
Well, Coach, complimenting that offense was the play of the offensive line.
Mm-hmm.
Hayes did have two turnovers, but still played and managed pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
They got on their blocks. Toby Antigua having a monstrous day, along with some of the other receivers, as we saw, making some outstanding catches.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I say, overall, it was a much better offensive performance. Anytime you can move the football like that against a really good team like Coastal, you're doing some good things. We got to stay away from the turnovers. That's a big part of it, And big games like that, penalties, turnovers, they always come to roost a little bit against you. So, again, really proud of the way the kids competed. We're playing a little bit better offensively. We need to continue that down the stretch here.
And on special teams, they've been playing lights out every year. Mm-hmm. That hit on that opening kickoff set the stage early because the defense forced them three and out. They only got 4 yards on their first possession.
Yeah, that was big. We got to continue to play well on special teams. Field position's big, our coverage units need to be good all year, and for the most part they've been. We got to continue to keep going on that.
All righty, Coach, let's take our first time out. When we come back, we're going to have the Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week. We'll take a look at the Blue Hose and the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, and also have a visit with one of our coaches, all ahead here on Inside Blue Hose Football.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And by Fats Cafe of Clinton.
Fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
This Big Bowl box is awesome, Mom.
Yep, enough chicken, biscuits, fixins, and tea for all of us.
You call that effort? Put your back into it!
Why don't you come over here and put your back into it?
Why doesn't it look like the box, Mr. Benson?
That's right.
Shh, honey, the longer he takes, the more we get to tailgate. Good job, hon.
Tailgate everything with Bojangles Big Bow Box. Grab a 12-piece super tailgate special. Bojangles, it's bow time.
Where'd you get that?
Oh, you won't believe what just happened.
Don't tell me you got the last Diet Dew.
Yeah.
I love the taste of Diet Dew. What do you want for it? Deal.
Diet Mountain Dew. Yeah, it tastes that good.
Hey, Hotshot. Meter's running.
Okay, what was that?
I don't know. It's over there.
Let's get out of here, Dew. Run!
Oh, hey.
How's it going?
McDonald's proudly serves McDonald's after midnight. A limited breakfast menu plus your late night favorites.
Look at those toys. Insurance must be expensive.
Nah.
I bet he's got an Allstate agent. They can save you up to 30% more by bundling your policy.
Well, his dog's stupid.
Poodles are one of the world's smartest breeds. Bundle and save with an Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you in part by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate and with Jeff Smith.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Bojangles, it's bow time. And by Pepsi, refresh everything.
Welcome you back, and Coach, let's talk about our Nichols automotive collision.
Yeah, you know, it was that kickoff, that opening kickoff that we talked about. You know, I mean, you know, Chris really has done a nice job in special teams and on offense this year, really kind of came into his own. He's an unselfish player, and that hit he made on that opening kickoff right there, knifing in on the hash, have him start the game at the minus 16 was big, and you know, we're going to have to continue to have collisions of the week like that, and hits of the week that sets tones for games, and really proud of the way that Chris has played all year.
Any chance, Chris, trying to talk you into letting him play on the edge on the defensive front?
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, I'm sure.
Let me lead into the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report. Mm-hmm. We've talked about it week after week. We do have some guys out, but bring us up to date if you would, please.
Yeah, we missed Mitchell Anderson, the defensive lineman. There didn't play in the game. Some other guys got some nicks and dings. Hopefully, we'll get John Hardy back. The offensive line's been out with that foot injury all year. Corey White's banged up. You know, was playing about 75% Saturday, and Deontay Davis has got a hand injury. So you get to that time of the year, down the stretch here where, some of those injuries start coming into play. Next guy's got to be up, and we've been next man up all year, and we got to continue to be that way. You know, finally got Curtis Bay back in the mix up front defensively, and he's come along and playing better. So, we got some guys that are nicked and ding. Those guys at Palmetto Bone and Joint, Dr. Milner and his crew do a great job, and they're going to have to work their magic, get some of these guys back for us down the stretch.
All righty, Coach. Now it's time for us to visit with one of our coaches as we take a look at Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm and Matt Davis is there.
Welcome to this week's edition of Coach's Corner. I'm Coach Joey Ork, offensive line coach. I have here with me Ryan Bristow, redshirt sophomore, North Carolina. We're going to demonstrate our stance. All right, we're going to start talking about stance here with Ryan. Okay, we're going to start with a basic normal down, every down stance that we're going to get in. Now we base our stance out of a 2-point stance, so that's what we're going to go ahead and get in. We want to start off first of all with him having a good toe to heel relationship. All right, with his stance and his base. Okay, his feet should be shoulder width apart. And you can see he'll get there. That'll change by player, by position, how we'll handle that. Bigger guys, Ryan's one of our bigger guys, will have a little bit wider stance because he's got wider shoulders. But we'll start with that good toe-to-heel, toe-to-instep relationship there in his stance. Okay, and then he's just going to bend down nice and easy for us. Go ahead and bend down, Ryan. It'll bend down nice and easy for us, all right, and get in that stance, okay? Big thing here, flat back, eyes and head up so we can see the defense, okay? And his elbows are going to be tucked tight on both sides, and he's going to bend at the knees, all right? Relax for me, Ryan. The important thing with our stance here is that we got to be able to move all directions from our stance. We got to go left, right, forward, and backwards as offensive linemen. So it's good to be in good balance when we get down in our stance. All right, now we're going to talk about how this stance changes a little bit, all right, particularly for Ryan at the tackle position when we get into a third and long situation where we're expecting a heavy pass rush. So go ahead and get down to the third and long stance, Ryan. Okay, you can see he's going to drop that right leg back. Ryan's on the right side, so he'll use his right leg. Okay, he'll drop that right leg back, get a little bit more of a stagger, anticipating the pass rush. This will allow him to get depth a little bit easier into his set. Okay, now we'll talk about a fourth down stance, fourth and short. Go ahead and relax, Ryan. We'll talk about a fourth and short stance where we expect to run the ball and the defense expects us to run the ball. Okay, that's when we'll get down into a three-point stance or even a four-point stance. So as we get down here, he goes into his two-point stance just like normal, and all we do here to get into a three-point stance is just have him place his hand down nice and easy as if his eyeball were to fall right out of his head and he were to pick it up. Okay? Again, things that can change here, we can get a little bit more forward lean on us, okay? Our base can widen a little bit here, and we can come off the ball a little bit easier for him. So that's how we can change our stance by down and distance and situation. Thanks for watching this week's edition of Coach's Corner. We look forward to having you back next week.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm and Matt Davis is there.
As always, Coach Harold Nichols and his coaching staff like to teach the game of football as well. Let's go ahead and take our final timeout. When we come back, the Buccaneers of Charleston Southern. This is a team that's been on a roll the last couple of years, and Presbyterian College knows the importance of this game in just a matter of a few minutes. We'll talk about that game, break it down when we return on Inside Blue Hose Football.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
Yeah, she's totally got this.
Not a chance.
And when she passes, she can join the tailgate party for some chicken biscuits, fixins, and tea.
I think I did really well. Yes. A big bow box?
Parking brake.
Tailgate everything with Bojangles Big Bow Box. Grab a 12-piece super tailgate special. Bojangles, it's bow time.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
In the NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision, the game is played with perseverance, integrity, passion, character, and sportsmanship as he works to honor the game and respect his teammates, opponents, officials, and fans. Every FCS player grows in his responsibilities as a student athlete and as a member of his campus and community. The NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision. Every down, every day.
Okay, what was that?
I don't know. It's over there.
Let's get out of here, dude. Run!
Oh, hey.
How's it going?
McDonald's proudly serves McDonald's after midnight. A limited breakfast menu plus your late night favorites.
I'm a hot babe out jogging. I'm out making sure this stays a 10 when you drive by. You're checking out my awesome headband when... Oops. That's when you find out your cut rate insurance, it ain't paying for this. So get Allstate. Save cash and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you in part by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate and with Jeff Smith. 106 West Main Street, Clinton.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by McDonald's of Lawrence and Clinton. I'm loving it. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you back. Well, Coach, break it down for us, because this is a Buccaneer team that played the Commodores of Vanderbilt to a one-point contest.
You know, they sure did. Charleston Southern played well all year. Right now they come into the game 5-1, their only loss being a one-point loss to Vanderbilt, an SEC team. They had a huge win at home early in the year against the Citadel. They're just a total football team. They've got a quarterback in Austin Brown, who is a transfer from UAB, who's done a really nice job for them in there, number four. They got Christian Reyes, who's a running back who did not play against Vanderbilt, but he's one of the better backs in our league. They've got Holloway back there in the backfield with him. They got Prater, a big tight end, this big target. And they finally got number three, Pereira, back, and he's been a really good receiver in our league for the last couple of years. They've made big improvements on the defensive side of the ball. They're so much better in the lines of scrimmage, both sides of the ball. They've got active linebackers. They play a lot of defensive sets where they like to bring pressure. So it's going to take a disciplined group on our defensive side of the ball. They'll run some option stuff. They like to trap you inside. They like to get you on play action pass. And Vanderbilt had a hard time stopping them. And then offensively, we're going to be able to pick up their pressure. And Hayes is going to have to play well. The quarterback position is going to have to play well. We have to do a good job all the way around. We've got to be good in teams. Huge, huge challenge going on the road.
And, Coach, still a lot more to play for, because if PC can pick up that victory, possibly run the table in conference play, they can find themselves in the playoffs as well. Harold Nichols, always a pleasure. Thank you for joining us. Make the trip down I-26, PC, and the Buccaneers in a matter of minutes. And thank you for joining us here on Inside Blue Hose Football.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And by Fats Cafe of Clinton.